All right. Now, once we have seen like different types of surfaces and their plane models, so we know how a torus can be constructed, how a sphere can be constructed. So what is this projective plane? So the projective plane is the surface with this very simple plane model, right? So it looks like just AA. So it's A and then A, but they point in the same direction. So here is my plane model. Now, according to the gluing instruction, I should glue like this A to this A, but I cannot glue it like this to make a sphere because, you know, if I glue it like this, this would mean that the direction of the arrows should go opposite, right? But if the direction of the arrows is the same, then what I really should do, I kind of should glue this side to this side with like a twist. But then it doesn't really make sense, right? You cannot really perform this in the three-dimensional space. But what you really see here is that what this means is that this point should be glued to this point, right? I don't know. This point should be glued to this point. This point should be glued to this point, and so on. In the projective, so the projective plane is just a disk with all pairs of opposite points on the boundary glued to each other, right? So we should glue these points together, these points together, these points together, and so on, right? So the projective plane is, well, right now it is just a hypothetical construction. So it is a disk. So we take a disk, and then we glue all pairs of opposite points on the boundary of the disk together. So, which is why schematically, very often, we kind of draw this projective plane like this. So we just draw a circle, and then we just do this just to indicate that all pairs of opposite points are glued to each other. So this is kind of a schematic figure for a projective plane, right? And if we have the connected sum of several projective planes, something like AA, BB, CC, then what we do, we draw a sphere, and then we draw like three of these. So one is AA, the other one BB, the third one CC. So this is some like a sort of schematic way to draw a projective plane. Now, the projective plane can also be thought of as the set of straight lines in R3 that pass through the origin. So which means this is the set of one-dimensional subspaces of R3. So, and this is a bit mind-blowing. Let me explain why this is so. So let me explain why this makes perfect sense. Now, so let me draw a coordinate system like X, Y, Z. So then every line that passes through the origin, so we probably have a line. This line is actually a point of our projective plane, right? So if our it doesn't mean that every point of this line is also a point of the projective plane. No, the whole line is just represents one point in our projective plane, right? So this kind of whole line belongs to our projective plane. So what does it mean? And how can we think about it? So I believe that the easiest way to think about it is to draw a little sphere here, right? And then if we have a line in the 3D space that passes through the origin, then it's going to also intersect our sphere at two opposite points, right? So at this point and at this point. So every line that passes through the origin intersects the unit sphere at two opposite points. But these two opposite points on the sphere, they represent the same point on the projective plane because it's still the same line, which really means that our projective plane is nothing else but the following construction. So we take our sphere, and then we glue all pairs of opposite points, something. So this point is glued to this point, this point is glued to this point, this point is glued to this point, and so on and so forth. So we take our sphere and we glue all pairs of opposite points on the sphere to each other. This is very similar to our construction here. Also, only, you know, in the previous slide, so we took a disc and we only glued opposite points on the boundary of the disc. And here we take the whole sphere and glue all pairs of opposite points, right? But, you know, if we glue, say, this point, say the North Pole to the South Pole. So there are two of them, and actually it, on the projective plane, it is the same point, right? So we don't really need this kind of North Pole to represent it. So we can just leave the South Pole here, right? So if we have, I say, this point and this point again, so we glue them to each other, so which means we do not kind of both of them to be there. So we can just remove one of them, forget about it, and whatever is here is going to represent this point on the projective plane, right? So my point being is that if we have any point in the upper hemisphere, it is going to be glued to the opposite point in the lower hemisphere, right? So which means that the point in the lower hemisphere can represent it in our projective plane. So we can just forget about this point in the upper hemisphere, so it's not needed. So which means that we can just forget about the whole upper hemisphere, which really means that this construction, so the sphere with pairs of opposite points identified to each other, just becomes just the lower hemisphere. But in this lower hemisphere, on the equator of the original sphere, we still, because we cannot really tell that this point is in the upper hemisphere and this point in the lower hemisphere. So both of them, they are on the equator, right? So they are kind of in between the upper hemisphere and the lower hemisphere, which means that we have to keep them here. So we have to still glue the opposite pairs of points on the equator. But this lower hemisphere is, of course, just homeomorphic to a disk, right? So because if we have our hemisphere, this is just homeomorphic to a disk. So, and this is how we can pass from this construction where the projective plane is the set of straight lines in the 3D space to this construction where the projective plane is thought of as the disk with opposite pairs of points glued to each other on the boundary, which ultimately is the something represented by the plane model AA, right? So this is the projective plane. And the projective plane indeed cannot be embedded into the three-dimensional space without self-intersection. So it is not a subset of the 3D, of the 3D space. But sometimes they visualize it like this, this cross-cap thing. And again, when you draw it, you don't really draw this weird construction. So when you draw a projective plane, what we usually do is just something like this.